Well, air pollution continues to be a risk factor for adverse health outcomes, especially respiratory and cardiovascular. In the United States, we've reduced the amount of pollution that we're exposed to, and that has helped. In fact, just a couple of years ago, we tried to estimate the improvement in life expectancy that would occur or has occurred as a result of reductions in air pollution. And these improvements in life expectancy due to reductions in air pollution have been significant in the U.S. That's not to say that air pollution in the U.S. still doesn't contribute to disease. And in fact, the most recent global burden of disease report has air pollution in sort of the top 10 risk factors for contributing to disease. The biggest impacts of air pollution, however, seem to be occurring in other parts of the world, places like China, places like India. There are many populations in the world that are exposed to very, very high concentrations of air pollution, and there are very significant adverse health outcomes associated with this exposure to the air pollution. So in the LA area, the primary pollutant of concern is PM2.5. In LA, the concentrations in the worst part of the LA metro area are about 20 to 25 micrograms per cubic meter on average. In Beijing, the average is about 100. So it's very difficult to compare exactly, but the concentrations of air pollution in Beijing are at least 3 or 4 times greater than what we see in our most polluted cities in the U.S. Some of the best news relative to the air pollution research over the last few years is the evidence that our reducing air pollution in the United States has resulted in measurable and significant increases in life expectancy and improved public health.